I should do what they're doing and fit in, or maybe I should be, you know, smart and not do it, right? And, you know, we can't really be prevented from acting with our conscience. So, and this is especially true when we think about our religious lives and what we believe about. So, that means that every single person that's created in the dignity of God has the freedom to follow their conscience when it comes to following God. So, it doesn't mean that you can be like, yeah, I'll do everything and my conscience is all good. And you then, like, at some point go against the church or what the church has taught. You're responsible for what you've learned about Christ, okay? You can't be ignorant on this knowledge, because you guys are all here and you're all receiving your formation, and you learned stuff, you know stuff, right? So, you know, now that, like, you know that it's wrong to sin, you know, you can't be like, oh, I didn't know, I had no idea. So the freedom that we get from God is that we have the ability to choose what's right, what's true, and what's good, and to resist the temptation to sin. So when we use this freedom that we have to do whatever the heck we want to do, we kind of really misunderstand what it means to be free. So instead of being free, we kind of become enslaved to things like addiction. Die in our souls. So happiness is a simple thing when you break it down. Everybody likes a happy face, right? So God has made this map for us, and all we have to do is follow it. And the map, the journey is going to be complicated along the way. So we have different people telling us that it's okay to do this sin. You know, it's going to be completely justified if you do this. And you have other people that are like, no, you shouldn't do this, you shouldn't do this. And it's almost like we need a referee or a judge. There we go. There's a to tell us when we're going off track.
No good.
Wait for it. Epic fail. Okay.
Yes. What?
That's only a regular type of fail.
That's an epic fail.
That's a regular type.
But the referee is the church. And the judge is the magisterium, and the map is the scriptures. Mm-hmm. So all God wants us to do is follow our conscience and mold it to this map that he's laid out for us. And play nicely by the rules that the referee has put out and take some recommendations from the judge. So you have to think of it this way. If either the church is right, or everything that the church... The church is the worst lie that's ever been propagated by humanity. So it seems to me like it's a pretty odd thing for so many of these type of people to die quite happily for a really big lie. So your challenge is to follow the natural law that God has placed on our hearts and use responsibility and follow.